My name is pronounced Frankenstein.
Oh.
Yes, yes, yes. The whole world knows about what my grandfather did, but I ask you, do I look like the kind of madman who prowls around graveyards digging up freshly buried corpses?
Well, Professor,
I'll answer that. I'm not a Frankenstein. I don't indulge in hijinks or tomfoolery. I'm not a Frankenstein. I don't believe in mummies, ghosts, or foolery. I hold back my mission. I am a scientist. I look for truth and reason. That's the reason I exist. There is a vast difference between my grandfather's delusional experiments and my own devotion to pure science. Which brings us directly to the subject of today's lecture. The brain. There is nothing like the brain. Hearts and lungs are simply tinker toys stacked against the brain. Insane! I'm insane about the brain. No invention in the universe is equal to the brain. The mouth's a marvel when it comes to eating. I'm nothing against the womb. I thank the bladder when I'm excreting, and I always give the elbow room. But the brain, please allow me to explain. There's no organ to compare to it. I swear to it, it's plain. It's the brain.
Sir!
Yes!
I'm not sure I understand that this between voluntary and involuntary nerve impulses.
Very good. Since our lab work today is a demonstration of just that distinction, Mr. Hilltop here, with whom I have never worked nor given any prior instruction to, has graciously offered his services for today's demonstration. Thank you, Mr. Hilltop. Now, his medulla oblongata tells the brain that it's got a sudden impulse full of data, which creates a lot of pain. His frontal lobe gets busy with the thought that makes him dizzy, puts his cortex in a taser so he never will complain. That's what I love about the brain. Mr. Hilltop, would you please hop up on your feet and stand next to your table? Nice hopping, Mr. Hilltop. Mr. Hilltop, would you raise your left knee, please? You have just witnessed a voluntary nerve impulse. Mr. Hilltop, you may lower your knee. Involuntary nerve impulses, on the other hand, are those which are made independently of the will. Why, you dirty, rotten, yellow son of a bitch! Even though I almost need him, his reflexes have the freedom to react when I mistreat him. It's important I explain. Synaptic connection goes away without detection, bringing cranial protection and never change. That's what I love about the brain. But what if we were to block those nerve impulses, which can be done with any ordinary metal clamp by simply applying local pressure, just with the swelling of the posterior nerve root for, oh, say, 4 seconds. Why, you mother-grabbing bastard! As you can see, even though I have just smashed my knee into his crotch, he does not react. He feels absolutely nothing. More or less. So, if it were not for this continuous stream of motor impulses from the brain, we would all collapse like a bunch of broccoli! And if you can say so, you can say it once again. Though your genitalia have been known to fail you, you can bet your ass on the brain. Everybody!
The brain! There is something like the brain! It's the king of our anatomy, and never shall we bring!
You can call me Copernicus, Kepler, Newton, Comparative Freud, and I feel like the call me a Darwin, I love that theory. Call me Pasteur, and watch me a theory. Say that I'm dreaming that way, they've been asked. Call me a worship, I'm up to the test. I'm right when you call me X, and call me an early guy. Love that medicine, call me Mark, call me that wireless wow. Call me a pop, I'll run like a child. Call me medicine, and I'll be fine if you call me a test. I'm willing to climb, but you call me a Frankenstein, we'll be insane. Cause I